Hello, my dear children. Good morning, all of you. Today, we will discuss about the second part of inequation. Question given, find the values of x which satisfying the inequation minus 2, 5 by 6 less than half, minus 2x by 3 less than equal to 2, x belongs to whole number. Graph the solution set on the number line. This is the sum. And now the solution. There are many ways you may solve this. One of them I will tell you. First, I want to break this inequation into two parts. First part, here to here. You may think, why up to here? That second inequality sign, up to second inequality sign, from first to second inequality sign, first part, and second part, the first inequality sign start from here and to the end. The first part, that is minus 2 5 by 6 less than half minus 2x by 3. Now we have to simplify. Minus 17 minus 3 by 6 less than minus 2x by 3, minus 20 by 6 less than minus 2x by 3, minus 10 by 2 less than minus x, minus 5 less than minus x. And last line, this is the less than sign, here is greater than sign. When you will see the minus value is coming in x, then you have to make it plus, and at the same time, the sign of inequality also will be the change, that is known to you very well. You have learned this in the previous class. So this less than sign will be greater than sign. So it will be 5 less than greater than x. Next, second part. Half minus 2x by 3 less than equal to 2. Half minus 2 less than equal to 2x by 3. 1 minus 4 by 2 less than equal to 2x by 3, minus 3 by 2 less than equal to 2x by 3, minus 9 less than equal to 4x, minus 9 by 4 less than equal to x, and minus 2.25 less than equal to x. Any fractional part, if you convert into decimal form, then it will be easier for plotting on the number line. This is why fractional part, my suggestion, you will convert into decimal form. After that, by combining these two, we are getting minus 2.25 less than equal to x less than 5. Up to this, if you do correctly, then you will get part marks, that is plus 1. Next, you have to write the solution set. Since x belongs to whole number, therefore the solution set within second bracket 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Why up to 4? Here we are getting less than 5. This is why up to 4. And it is given, belongs to whole number. This is why whole number is starting from 0. This is why it will start from 0 and up to 4. Here, one thing you have to remember, in case of real number, you have to write the solution set in set builder notation that you have seen in the previous class. And in case of whole number, natural number and integer, you have to write the solution set in roster form in this way. After this, if you do correct, then you will get another part marks plus 1. Then you have to represent the solution set on the number line. Then the number line, for number line, we have to draw a straight line. After drawing the straight line, you have to put two arrows at the two ends, that is known to you very well. Then you have to give the name of the straight line x, x dash. After giving the name, then you have to plot the solution on the number line. Here, 0. Before plotting, you have to make the scale, see the 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, gap between, that is between two values must be uniform, right side that is plus, left hand side that is minus. And here in case of whole number you have to draw the number line by dark circle in this way, and no need of shading between two values, only dark circle in this way. Up to this, in this way, if you do correctly, then another part marks, that is plus one. Before that, one thing I have missed to tell in the previous class, that is vital part. Please pay attention to listen that. Required solution, that is 0 to 4, but here I have done here 5 more and this side many. You have to remember what required solution you have got, at least one either side you have to show more. That is, we got 4, here we have to show at least one value, that is 5. If you miss this, then marks for number line you will miss. Remember this. This is applicable in whole number, natural number, and integer, and real number also. So remember this. This is the vital. Then after this, the solution of the question. If you do correctly, then you will get 3 marks. There are another point, that is, instead of whole number, if it is given natural number, in that case the solution set will be 1, 2, 3, 4, because natural number is starting from 1. After writing the solution set, you have to plot the solution on the number line except 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 in this way. And then another point, that is x, when x belongs to integer, then the solution set minus 2. Why minus 2? Here less than equal to 2.25, so it will be up to minus 2. Fractional part will not be considered because it is integer. In case of real number, fractional value, decimal value will be accepted. But in case of integer, natural number, whole number, fractional part will not be considered, that means minus 2. The solution set will start from minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, up to 4. After writing the solution set, then you have to represent the solution set on the number line. That is known to you very well. You have to draw the line. After drawing the line, you have to draw the arrow marks either side. Then you have to give the name of the straight line, x, x dash. After giving the name, then you have to plot the point with the dark circle in this way, without shading between two dark circles. You must remember the shading only applicable in case of real number. Others, that is whole number, natural number, integer, in these cases, that only you have to draw the number line by dark circle. Remember this. This is the vital part between real number and whole number, natural number, and integer. I think you are understanding, but if you feel any difficulties, any sorts of problem, if you feel, you don't worry, you must inform me. I am always with you. Thank you, everybody.